Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss about the two important properties of the DFT. So already in the previous video, we discussed the three properties. One is the linearity property. The second one is the periodicity property. And the third one is a circular convolution property. Okay, so today we are going to discuss about the circular time shift and a circular frequency shift property of the DFT. Okay, so these two properties are important property. Okay, so you must study. So you see the first we are going to discuss about the circular time shift property, okay, of DFT. So in order to define the circular time shift, so already we studied the time shifting property in all transforms. Okay, that is in Fourier transform, discrete time Fourier transform, then Z transform and Laplace transform. In all transform, we studied the time shifting property. What does mean by time shifting property? If we want to find the particular answer, okay, the transformed value of that time shifted signal is calculated using this property. So here, there is not a simply time shift, it is a circular time shift. Okay, so what is the difference between time shift, ordinary time shift and a circular time shift means? So if it is a time shift means, that is, you see, you just consider the sequence 1 comma 2 comma 3. Okay, so 1 comma 2 comma 3, here the three samples are there. Here the index is the origin value of this x of n is this one. Okay, that is, at n equal to 0, the signal is having value 1. At n equal to 1, the signal is having value 2. At n equal to 3, the signal is having the value 3. Okay, so this is the x of n sequence. So if you are performing the ordinary time shift means, that is x of n minus 1. For example, we are shifting this sequence by 1 second. Okay, so if you are shifting this x of n sequence by 1 second to the right side means, so what is the data we will get means 0 comma 1 comma 2 comma 3. Okay, so you see the index value. So here this one, the amplitude 1, it is shifted to the time index n equal to 1. Okay, so at n equal to 0, what is the amplitude means? The 0 will come. So here the index is changed in an ordinary time shift. But here we are going to discuss about the circular time shift. What does it mean by circular time shift means? In circular time shift, the index value is not changing. Okay, that is, you see, the x of n sequence is having the lower index is 0. That is, at n equal to 0, the sequence it will start. At n equal to, this is n equal to 1, this is n equal to 2. So, the x of n, it starts at n equal to 0 and it ends at n equal to 2 only. Okay, so the circular shifting means, the circular shifting of this x of n by the time 1 means, that is, what is the meaning means? This amplitude 1 is shifted to this position and the amplitude 2 is shifted to this amplitude 3 position and this amplitude 3 is shifted to this amplitude 1 position. Okay, so again, so what are the data we will get after this circular time shift means? The answer is 3 comma 1 comma 2. Okay, so this 3 is the lower index at n equal to 0. So at n equal to 0, the shifted sequence is having the amplitude 3. And n equal to 1, 1. At n equal to 2, the amplitude is 2. So this is said to be the circular time shift. So you see the difference. If you are performing ordinary time shift, we will get the answer x of n minus 1 is 0 comma 1 comma 2 comma 3. So the sequence starts at n equal to 0. If it is a circular time shift means at n equal to 0, the 3, this value, this last value, it will come to the first position and this sequence is shifted to here, this sequence is shifted to here. Okay, so this shifting, we are calling it as a circular time shift. Okay, so what is the answer for this circular time shifted sequence? We are going to calculate using the circular time shifting property. Okay, so first we are going to define this property. If the sequence x of n is having the DFT value is capital X of k, okay, then the circular time shifted sequence, we have to write it as x of n minus m, the circular, in order to indicate the circular time shift, again, we have to put one bracket and within that, we have to write capital N. So what is the meaning of this double bracket means? It is a circular time shift of n minus, that is the x of n shifted by the amount m samples. Okay. And the sequence is circularly time shift by the n point DFT, capital N we have to mention. Okay. So if you want to find out the DFT of this time shifted sequence means, so the answer is that the same x of k value multiplied with e power minus j 2 pi k m divided by capital N, where this m is said to be the amount of shift. Okay. And here this x of n minus m, n, this is said to be the circular time shifted signal by m samples. Okay. So simply if you are writing x of n minus m, only one bracket if you are putting means that is called as an ordinary time shift. So if it is a circular time shift means we have to mention it as a double bracket, and over that we have to write capital N. So this is called as a circular time shift. So within N sample, the values are shifting. Okay. So you see in this thing, within this three sample, the values are shifting. So this this amplitude three is not shifted to the next position. The amplitude three is shifted to the first position. Okay. Within the index, the amplitudes are shifting. It is called as a circular time shifting. Okay. So now we have to prove this one. Okay. So in order to prove this one, so first we have to take the ordinary DFT formula. Okay. So as per the DFT definition, the DFT of any signal x of n, it can be written as summation n equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n e power minus j 2 pi k n by n. Okay. This is our DFT formula. So what is our aim? Our aim is to calculate the DFT of this circular time shifted sequence x of n minus m over n. Okay. So that's why therefore the DFT of x of n minus m over n, it can be written as, so instead of this x of n, we have to put this circular time shifted signal x of n minus m over the circular time shift n, okay, into e power minus j 2 pi k n divided by n. Okay, so now we have to prove this answer as capital X of k multiplied with this e power minus j 2 pi k m divided by m. Okay, so in order to prove this one, so we are going to do some modifications. Okay, so what is the first step means, so we have to split this, you see the summation limit, the summation limit actually n equal to 0 to n minus 1. So I am going to split this summation into two things. One is n equal to 0 to m minus 1, and n equal to, what is the next, the index value is m. Okay, after m minus 1, n equal to m to n minus 1. So we have to split this 0 to n minus 1 summation, we are splitting into 0 to m minus 1, that value plus summation n equal to m to n minus 1, that same value. Okay. So in that, we have to find out the answer for this first summation and second summation separately. And we are going to substitute the answer in this equation. Okay. So in that thing, you see this value, what is x of n minus m? The circular time shifted value x of n minus m over n means, so you see in a circular time shifted value, the x of n minus m over n, it can be written as, it is equivalent to x of capital N minus m plus n. Okay, so you have to write x of this n, and within the within this bracket, what is the value available, you just write the value. So x of capital N plus n minus m. Okay, so this x of n minus this circular shifted value, it is ordinarily can be written as this one. Okay, so wherever this x of n minus m circular time shifted signal x of n minus m available, so instead of that one, you may replace this thing also. Okay, so therefore the DFT of x of n minus m over n, the formula, it can be written as summation n equal to 0 to m minus 1. So instead of this x of n minus m over n, we have to put x of capital N minus m plus n into e power this thing plus summation n equal to m to n minus 1 x of this one, you just write. Okay, so you consider this is equation number 1. So next thing, so in this equation number 1, there are two terms there. Okay, so two summation term is that. So we are going to calculate the value of the first summation and the second summation separately, and we have to substitute in this equation number one. Okay, so first one. So in order to calculate this answer, so first you see here the sequence x of what are the term available? The three terms are available. X of capital N minus M plus N. Okay. So now we have to consider this this variable addition subtraction. You have to consider as a one new variable L. Okay. So let capital N minus M plus N. You just take it as a L. Okay. So you just replace so wherever the capital N minus M plus N available, you just replace it with the new variable N. Okay, new variable L. So that's why you just write the this first term. Okay, you take this first term in equation number one. You just take the first term. Okay, this first term we are going to calculate the answer for this first term and answer for the second term separately, and finally we have to add these two answer, means we will get the total DFT answer. Okay, so the first term I am taking. So the first term, you see, summation n equal to 0 to m minus 1, the x of n minus m over n, that is x of capital N minus m plus n into e power minus j 2 pi k n by n, it can be written as, okay. So instead of this n minus m plus n, we have to put L, okay. Then in the place of n, okay, wherever the variable n and this n minus m n available, you just replace it with the new variable L. So that's why instead of this small n we have to put, so you see this equation. So from this, what is the value of n? N is equal to L minus capital N plus small m. Okay, so you just replace this n divided by L plus m minus n. Okay, and so if you are changing the old variable into new variable, means automatically the limit is also changing. Okay, so you see, what is the old limit? When n tends to 0. Okay, so you see the lower limit is the old variable n tends to 0. So if the small n tends to 0, means what is the new variable L? So n minus m plus 0. So that's why you see the lower limit is L is from capital N minus 1. And what is the upper limit? You see, N is M minus 1. So you just replace this N by M minus 1, means so we will get capital N minus 1. Okay. So that's why the answer for this first summation is this one. Okay. And in this thing, you just replace, you just expand this e power. So here in e power, there are three terms there. So you just expand it. So e power minus j 2 pi k L plus M divided by N, okay, into e power minus 2 pi k, then minus of minus plus N divided by N, N cancel. So that's why we will get the second term, e power j 2 pi k. Okay, so what is the value of e power j 2 pi k? The e power j 2 pi k value is 1 for any value of k. Okay, since e power j theta, we can written as cos theta plus j sine theta. Okay. So in the place of theta, what is the term is available? 2 pi k. So cos 2 pi k plus j sine 2 pi k. So what is cos 2 pi k? The cos 2 pi k, it is always 1. Okay. So that's why the e power j 2 pi k value, it is equal to 1. Okay. So you just substitute the thing in above equation. So we will get summation L equal to N minus 1 to N minus 1. Okay, N minus M to N minus 1 X of L into e power minus J 2 pi K L plus M divided by N. So you consider this is the equation number 2. Okay, so similarly, so this is the answer for the first term. Okay, this is the answer for the first term in equation number 1. Similarly, we have to calculate the answer for the second summation. Okay, what is the summation? Summation n equal to m to n minus 1, x of n minus m plus n into this thing. Okay, so we have to calculate the answer for the second summation. So if you are calculating the answer for the second summation, so we will get the answer is that summation l equal to 0 to n minus 1 minus m into x of l into e power minus j 2 pi k L plus M divided by N. Okay, so similar to the previous answer, the same answer will come except the limit. What is the limit? Means L equal to 0 to n minus 1 minus m. So this is the answer for the second term in equation number 1. Okay. So you just consider this is the equation number 3. So then we have to substitute the value of this equation number 2 and equation number 3 in equation number 1 in order to get the total DFT. Okay. So the DFT of the circular time shifted signal, it gives the answer is that. So you see, the answer for the first summation is this one and answer for the second summation is this one. Okay. So you see here the terms are equal. X of L e power minus j 2 pi k L plus m by n. Similarly, X of L e power minus j 2 pi k L plus m divided by n. Same term is available. And you see the summation limit. So here the summation limit is L equal to 0 to n minus 1 minus n. And you see the summation limit here. What is this upper limit? You see n minus m minus 1. What is the next data of this upper limit? N minus m. So you see this summation, it starts from the next value n minus m to n minus 1. Okay. So if you are adding these two summation means we can written as summation L equal to 0 to n minus 1. Okay. If you are adding these two summation, we will get the total limit is from L equal to 0 to n minus 1, x of L e power minus j 2 pi k L by n into e power minus j 2 pi k m divided by n. Okay, so we got the answer. So you see in this thing, so here the summation L equal to 0 to n minus 1, x of L into e power minus j 2 pi k L by n, you see. So this term is resemblance to the DFT formula. So what is the DFT of any sequence x of n summation n equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n e power minus j 2 pi k n by n. Okay. So instead of the small n here, there is a variable L is there. Okay. So that's why this formula is that this is the DFT of our given sequence, given time domain sequence x of L. Okay. Except this term. So that's why this answer, it can be written as capital X of K. Okay. Multiplied with, what is the remaining answer? E power minus J 2 pi K M divided by N. Okay. So we proved the circular time shifted property. Okay. So therefore, the DFT of any circularly time shifted signal by amount M sample, it is nothing but the DFT answer, the original DFT answer of the x of n multiplied with the constant e power minus j 2 pi k m divided by n. Okay. So this is the circular time shifting property. Okay. Then the next property we are going to discuss is a circular frequency shifting property. So here, in the previous property, the sequence, the time domain sequence is shifted. Okay. Shifted means, so what is the corresponding answer in DFT we discussed? So here, there is a shifting in frequency domain. Okay. So you see, if the sequence X of N is having the DFT answer is capital X of K means, then you see here in frequency domain sequence, the K, X of K is shifted by the amount L. Okay, shifted by the amount L. So when we are getting this frequency shifted answer means, so if you are taking DFT for that sequence X of N multiplied with one data, what is the data? E power J 2 pi L N divided by N. Okay, if any sequence X of N multiplied with E power J 2 pi L N divided by N means for that sequence, if you are taking DFT answer means that the DFT answer is the circular frequency shifting answer for our original DFT by the amount L second. This is said to be the frequency, circular frequency shifting property. Okay, so now we are going to prove this property. So this proof is very simple. So first you just write the ordinary DFT formula. But here, our aim is to find out the DFT of this complete answer. So therefore, the DFT of the sequence X of N multiplied with e power J 2 pi L N by N. It can be written as, what is the DFT formula? Summation N equal to 0 to N minus 1. The given sequence, what is the given sequence? X of N multiplied with e power J 2 pi L by N into e power minus j 2 pi k n divided by n. Okay, so in this you see there are two e power term is there. Okay, so the base is common, so you have to add the powers. So in the power, which one is common? You see j 2 pi n by n is a common in this two term. So we have to write it as summation n equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n into e power, if you are taking minus j 2 pi n by n as a common, we have to write here which one is the missing, k is missing, here minus l is missing. So that's why we can write as e power minus j 2 pi n k minus l divided by n. Okay, so after combining we will get the answer like this. Okay, so what is our aim means? Our aim is to prove the answer for the summation is that x of k minus l circular shifted. Okay, circular frequency shift k minus l. So already you know the x of k minus l, this double double bracket over the n, it can be written as, it can be written as a capital X of, okay, n, okay, capital X of the capital N, then you just write this value. So n plus k minus l. Okay, so this is the ordinary thing. Okay, this is nothing but a circular time shift, the circular shift, this is the ordinary shift. So this answer is always equal to this thing. Okay, so in order to prove like that one, so we are multiplying in the above. Okay, in this equation, so you just multiply this entire term with e power minus j 2 pi n n divided by n. Okay, so you see what is the value of e power minus, that is n cancel. Okay, n is cancel, that is e power minus j 2 pi n. What is the value of e power minus j 2 pi n? 1. Okay, so that's why in this term I am multiplying with 1. Okay, so instead of this 1, okay, if you are multiplying with 1 means there is no change in the previous data also. That's why instead of this one, we have to put e power minus j 2 pi n divided by n. Okay, so if you are multiplying this answer with this one, and if you are taking the common term means, we will get e power minus j 2 pi n. Okay, so in this term, j 2 pi n as a common, we have to write capital N plus k minus l. Okay, so you see this equation. What is this equation? So this equation is resemblance to the ordinary DFT formula. Okay, so what is the DFT formula of any sequence x of n? Summation n equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n into e power minus j 2 pi k n by n. So in the place of k, okay, instead of k, here there will be an answer n plus k minus l is there. Okay, so that's why if k is there means we have to write this entire answer as a capital X of k. But in the place of k, what is the thing is there? N plus k minus l is there. So that's why the answer for this summation, it can be written as capital X of n plus k minus l. Okay, so we got the answer. So what is X of n plus k minus l? It can be written as a circular frequency shift of x of the double bracket of k minus l over n, we have to write. Okay, so we proved the circular frequency shifting property. So any sequence x of n multiplied with e power j 2 pi l n by n means the DFT answer for this multiplication sequence answer is that this sequence, the DFT answer is shifted by the L amount in a circular time shifting thing. Okay, so this property, it is called as a circular time shifting property. Okay, so in this video, we discussed the two properties. One is a circular time shifting property and another one is a circular frequency shifting property. Okay, so these two properties are very important properties. So if they are mentioning means they may ask this frequency shifting property as well as the time shifting property. Okay, so thanks for watching my channel. And in the next video, so we will discuss about the remaining two properties, time reversal property and a complex conjugate property of the DFT. Okay, so thanks for watching my channel and keep watching. So share this video to your friends also. Thank you.